this video, we will discuss the DMA controller. Direct Memory Access Controller. The method that is used to transfer information between internal storage and external I/O devices is known as I/O interface. The CPU is interfaced using special communication link by peripherals connected to any computer system. These communication link are used to resolve the differences between CPU and peripheral. So these exist special hardware components between CPU and peripheral to supervise and synchronize all the input and output transfer that are called interface units. So here mode of transfer, that is a binary information that is received from an external device, is usually stored in memory unit. The information that is transferred from the CPU to the external device is originated from the memory unit. Then the CPU merely process the information, but the source and target is always the memory unit. Data transfer between CPU and I/O device may be done in different modes. Data transfer to and from the peripherals may be done in any of the three possible ways. The first one is a programmable I/O, second one interrupt initiated I/O, and third one direct memory access DMA. Now let's discuss each mode one by one. Programmed I/O. So programmed I/O means it is due to the result of the I/O instruction that are written in the computer program. Each data item transfer is initially by an instruction in the program. Usually the transfer is from CPU register and memory. In this case, it requires a constant monitoring by the CPU of the peripheral devices. Then examples of a programmed I/O. The I/O device does not have direct access to the memory unit. The transfer from I/O device to memory requires the execution of several instructions by the CPU, including input instruction to transfer the data from the device to the CPU and store instruction to transfer the data from the CPU to memory. In programmed I/O, the CPU stays in the program loop until the I/O unit indicates that it is ready for data transfer. So this is a time-consuming process since it needlessly keeps the CPU busy. Then that is the second type, that is interrupt initiated I/O. Since in the above case we saw the CPU is kept busy unnecessarily. So this situation can very well be avoided by using an interrupt driven method for data transfer. By using interrupt facility and special command to inform the interface to issue the interrupt request signal whenever the data is available from any device. So in the meantime, the CPU can proceed for any other program execution. The interface meanwhile keeps monitoring the device. Whenever it is determined that the device is ready for data transfer, it initiates an interrupt request signal to the computer. Upon detection of an external interrupt signal, the CPU stops momentarily the task that it was already performing, branches to the service program to process the I/O transfer, and then return to the task it was originally performing. Okay, then third type, that is a direct memory access. The data transfer between a fast storage media such as a magnetic disk and memory unit is limited by the speed of the CPU. Thus, we can allow the peripheral directly communicate with each other using the memory buses, removing the intervention of the CPU. So this type of data transfer technique is known as DMA, direct memory access. During DMA, the CPU is idle and it has no control over the memory buses. The DMA controller takes over the buses to manage the transfer directly between the I/O devices and memory unit. For that, it needs two signals. One is a bus request signal, another one bus grant signal. Bus request signal is used by the DMA controller to request the CPU to get the control of the buses from the CPU. Whereas bus grant means it is activated by the CPU to inform the external DMA controller that the buses are high impedance state and the requesting DMA can take control of these buses. Once the DMA has taken the control of these buses, it transfers the data. This transfer can take place in many ways. Okay, that is the first one, that is the types of DMA transfer using DMA controller. The first one, burst mode or burst transfer. So DMA returns the bus after complete data transfer. So yeah, register is used as a byte count being decremented for each byte transfer. And upon the byte count reaching zero, the DMAC, that is a direct memory access controller, will release the buses. When the DMAC operates in burst mode, the CPU is halted for the duration of the data transfer. Then the steps are, the first one is a bus grant request time, then transfer the entire block of data at a transfer rate of the device, because the device is usually slow than the speed at which the data can be transferred to the CPU. Then after that, release the control of the bus back to the CPU. So total time taken to transfer the n bytes, that is equal to bus grant request time plus n into memory transfer rate plus bus release control time. So this is called burst mode of data transfer. Then second type, that is a cycle stealing. So cycle stealing means an alternative method in which a DMA controller transfer one word at a time, after which it must return the control of the buses to the CPU. The CPU delays its operation only for one memory cycle to allow the direct memory IO transfer to steal one memory cycle. Here four steps are involved. The first step, buffer the byte into the buffer, then inform the CPU that the device has one byte to transfer, that is a bus grant request. Then third step, transfer the byte at system bus speed. Then fourth step, release the control of the bus back to the CPU. Okay, so before moving on transfer next byte of data, device performs step one again so that bus is not tied up and the transfer won't depend upon the transfer rate of the device. So for one byte of transfer of data, time taken by using cycle stealing mode is time required for bus grant plus one bus cycle to transfer data plus time required to release the bus. So it will be n into t. In cycle stealing mode, we always follow pipelining concept, that when one byte is getting transferred, then device is parallel preparing the next byte. The fraction of CPU time to the data transfer time, if asked, then cycle stealing mode is used. So this method is called as a direct memory access. See this diagram. So this is also circuit arrangement. So this is block diagram. So this is circuit diagram. So this is bus interface unit. So this is DMA controller, memory, then device send receive from RAM device. So here what are the lines used? One is a hold acknowledgement signal, another one request signal. Okay, similarly here, one signal for DMA request, another one for acknowledgement signal, then address bus, data bus. So this is IO bus. So this is chip select signal, then write signal. Okay, from decoder memory select. So this is circuit arrangement or circuit diagram of DMA controller. Thank you.